Which I was driven away these Reading from the prophecy of Isaiah. Unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, whose government is to come upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called the Angel of Great Counsel, Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, He that hath authority, the Prince of Peace, the Father of the age to come. For I will bring peace upon the princes, and peace and health to him. His government shall be great, and of his peace there is no end. It shall be upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom, to establish it, and to support it in judgment and righteousness, from henceforth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of Sabaoth shall perform this.
Wisdom.
The readings from the prophecy of Isaiah. The Lord again spoke to Ahaz, saying, Ask for thyself a sign from the Lord thy God, in the depth or in the height. And Ahaz said, I will not ask, neither will I tempt the Lord. And Isaiah said, Hear ye now, O house of David, is it a little thing for you to contend with men? And how do ye contend against the Lord? Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive in the womb, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel. Butter and honey shall he eat. Before he even knoweth to prefer evil, he shall choose the good. For before the child shall know good or evil, he refuseth evil to choose the good. And the Lord said to me, Take to thyself a volume of a great new book, and write in it with a man's pen concerning the making a rapid plunder of spoils, for it is near at hand. And make me witnesses of faithful men, Uriah the priest, and Zacharias the son of Jeberechiah. And I went into the prophetess, and she conceived and bore a son. And the Lord said to me, Call his name, spoil quickly, plunder speedily. For before the child shall know how to call father or mother, he shall take the power of Damascus and the spoils of Samaria before the king of the Assyrians. God is with us. Know ye nations, and be vanquished. Give ear, even unto the utmost part of the earth. Ye that have prevailed, even ye be vanquished. For though ye should prevail again, yet again shall ye be vanquished. And whatsoever counsel ye shall take, the Lord shall bring it to naught. And whatsoever word ye speak, it shall not abide in you. For God is with us.
Bless you, Amen.
The Lord hath said to me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. Ask of me, and I will give thee the Gentiles for thine inheritance.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Hebrews.
Bless you, Amen.
God, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the ages, who, being the effulgence of his glory and the express image of his hypostasis, upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. For unto which of the angels did he say at any time, Thou art my son, this day have I forgotten thee, have I begotten thee? And again, I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son. And again, when he bringeth in the firstborn into the world, he saith, And let all the angels of God worship him. And of the angels he saith, Who maketh his angels spirits, and his ministers a flame of fire? But unto the son he saith, Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of uprightness is the scepter of thy kingdom. Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore God, thy God, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness more than thy fellows. And thou, Lord, in the beginning didst lay the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the works of thy hands. They shall perish, but thou abidest, and all like a garment shall grow old. And as a venture shalt thou fold them, and they shall be changed. But thou art the same, and thy years shall not fail.
Thank you. Assyria, and all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in that region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night, and an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying which had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them.
Members.
Jesus, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
God, the Holy, the Holy, perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
And this, O Lord.
Unable to be as a man of God, in charge of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
And this, O Lord.
Our condition of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
And this, O Lord.
on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for all pious and orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy.
Metropolitan Joseph and our father and Bishop Demetri.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for every Christian soul afflicted and weary in need of God's mercy and help, for the protection of this holy house, for those who sing therein, and the people here present, for the peace and stability of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, for the salvation and help of our fathers and brethren, who with diligence and fear of God labor and serve, for those who are gone away, those who are abroad, for those who travel by sea, land, and air, for the healing of those who lie in infirmity, for the deliverance of captives, for those in prison and in danger, for our brethren who are serving, who are remembered for their labor, for all who await the mercies of God, let us say,
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation, pardon and forgiveness of sins for the servants of God, the parishioners, members of the parish council, organizations, donors, and benefactors, Holy Temple, those here present who celebrate this holy feast.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray that he may keep this holy church, this city, from every city and every city and countryside, from wrath, famine, plague, earthquake, flood, fire, the sword, foreign invasion, civil war, and sudden death, that our good God, who loves mankind, will be gracious, favorable, and conciliatory, and turn away and dispel all the wrath stirred up against us in all sickness, and may deliver us from his righteous chastisement with dependence on us, and have mercy on
us. Mercy, Lord, 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 mercy.
Again, we pray that the Lord our God may hearken unto the voice of the supplication of sinners and have mercy on us. Salvation through the intercessions of all Immaculate Lady Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at supplications of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, laudable apostles Peter and Paul, and of all the holy apostles, of our Father among the saints, great hierarchs, ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, John Chrysostom, Athanasios, Cyril and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Prometheus, Nectarius of Pentapolis, the Wonder Workers, of our Father among the saints, Tikhon, the Patriarch of Moscow, and Rafael, the Bishop of Brooklyn, the patron and protector of this church, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Merce Dreamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, Minos the Wonder Worker, of the hero martyrs, Ignatius, God-Bearer of Antioch, Carlampos, Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kitiaki, Botini, Marina, Paris Cave, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, red victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, shown the ascetic life, and of all the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints.
May God prayer accept the will.
Amen.
And thus forgiveness of our sins.
Amen.
Shelter us under the shelter of thy wings.
Amen.
Drive away from us every enemy and adversary.
Amen.
Give peace to our life, O Lord. Have mercy on us and on thy word. Save our souls, for thou art merciful and lovest mankind.
Amen.
Satisfy the 5,000 therewith. Thyself bless these loaves, this sweet wine and oil. Multiply them in this city and in the houses of those who celebrate this feast and in all thy work. For sanctify the faithful who partake of them. For it is thou who dost bless and sanctify all things, O Christ our God. And unto thee we send up glory, together with thy Father, who is from everlasting, and thine all holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Rejoice, O rich man, have turned poor and gone hungry. But they that seek the Lord shall not be deprived of any good thing.
Rich men have turned poor and gone hungry, but they that seek the Lord shall not be deprived of any good thing. Rich men have turned poor and
Gives me the greatest honor and pleasure to ordain my great nephew, they call me grandpa, my grandson, to the degree of preacher then subdeacon. They are minor orders in the church. Demetri Khoury is the electric engineer. He works in Atlanta. His father was priest. His grandfather was priest, his uncle is a bishop, and he helped a great deal in establishing a mission in Granbury, Pennsylvania. So who knows what God will lead him from here. Let us all keep him in his, in your prayer and in God's protection. Let us pray to the Lord. O Lord, who enlightens the and all created things with the light of thy marvels and knowest the intent of every man before it is formed, and transformest those who are desirous of serving thee. Do thou the same, Lord, array in thy fair and spotless vesture this thy servant, Demetri, who desired to become a reader. Before thy holy mysteries, that he may be illumined, and that attaining unto the word to come, he may receive the incorruptible crown of life, and rejoice with thine elect in bliss everlasting. For hallowed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. The servant of God, Demetri, is sworn in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord God Almighty, in this thy servant, elect this thy servant and sanctify him and enable him with all wisdom and understanding to exercise the study, reading of thy divine words, preserving him in blamelessness in life. Through the mercies and bounties and love toward men of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed together with thine all holy good and life giving spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Let us attend.
And we know that the Son of God has come and has given us understanding to know him who is true, and we are in him who is true, and in his Son, Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life. Little children, keep yourself from idols. Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
My son, the first degree in the priesthood is that of reader. It behooves you, therefore, to study the divine scripture daily, to the end that the hearers regarding you may receive edification, that you in no way, shaming your election, may prepare yourself for a higher degree. For by a chaste, holy, and upright life, you shall gain the favor of the God of loving kindness, and shall render him yourself worthy of great ministry through Jesus Christ our Lord. and our God, to whom belong glory and honor and worship, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. He is worthy.
He is worthy.
Distributing gifts of grace to each one of those whom thou hast chosen, has given to thy church diverse orders, who through thine inscrutable providence hast appointed degrees of ministry therein, for the service of thy holy, spotless mysteries, and who through thine ineffable foreknowledge hast ordained this thy servant to be worthy to serve in thy holy church. Do thou the same, Lord, preserve him uncondemned in all things, and grant that he may love the beauty of thy house, stand before the doors of thy holy temple, and kindle the lamps in the tabernacle of thy glory, and plant in him thy holy church like a fruitful olive trees, which bringeth forth the fruits of righteousness, and make him thy perfect servant in thy time of thy advent, that he may receive the recompense of those who are well-pleasing unto thee. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. You who are faithful. You who are faithful. Ye who are faithful.
He is worthy.
He is worthy.
Mustahak.
Mustahak.
Axios.
Axios. Axios. Axios. Axios.
He is worthy.
He is worthy.
Mustahak.
Mustahak.
Axios.
Axios.
Departed. mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Intercession of His Holy Immaculate, Holy Blameless, Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the Honorable Father, Spouse of Heaven, at the supplication of the Honorable Glorious Prophet John the Baptist, of the Holy Glorious and all laudable Apostles, of the Holy Glorious and Right Victorious Martyrs, of our Venerable God-bearing Fathers, Saint Raphael, Patron Saint of this Holy Community, of the Holy and Righteous and Sister of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind.
Save us.
Rejoice, O onward.